Talking about the different symptoms between osteoarthritis and rheumatoid arthritis, I think my obsession with color coding will really pay off. So we'll have red for rheumatoid arthritis and green for osteoarthritis. We'll talk about all the different symptoms, but I want to make this a logical discussion. So keep thinking back to the cause of these two diseases and why it is that they are different in symptoms. So in rheumatoid arthritis, it's always going to be autoimmune. So the body's attacking itself. It's a whole body kind of process. Whereas in osteoarthritis, we're dealing with overuse. Usually in elderly people or people carrying extra weight weighing down their joints. Okay, first before the differences, let's just quickly go over the commonalities and why it's important to distinguish them because people will come in complaining of the same things. Pain, number one, their joints hurt. Both of these can be painful. They can also involve stiffness. The quality and timing of it will be different, but they'll both tell you that their joints feel stiff and they can't use them well. So with that, they might avoid using their limbs, might lead to muscular weakness. Weakness, loss of function. And this weakness and loss of function and inability to do the things they like to do might actually have indirect effects on their mood, for example, depression. Is common because both of these can, or they are, chronic diseases. So, depression, risk for heart disease, and other things from a sedentary lifestyle are all things to consider. So, the point of this is when patients come in and tell you my joints hurt, make sure to not leave it at that and keep asking the questions to distinguish the two. And the first question you might ask is, where does it hurt? Which joints? And here, a very important feature that distinguishes the two is going to be the fact that in rheumatoid arthritis, we have symmetry between the left side and the right side of the body. So, for example, when a person with RA comes in and tells you, my shoulders hurt, it's going to be shoulders, left and right. I tell you, my knees hurt, it's going to be likely left and right knee. So when you just think of location, there can be overlap. For example, both of these can lead to painful knees, but in rheumatoid arthritis, it's more likely to be both sides. Again, wrists, elbows, both sides. Whereas here on this side, we have often asymmetry. Because OA comes from wear and tear on the joints, and sometimes the use is going to be not even between the left and right side of the body. And also the cartilage that we start out with might not be the same. So for these people, they can have one shoulder, the other knee, maybe the same ankle, and the other wrist. The pattern of it is going to look more like this. So symmetry, very important clue. Also, the specific locations is really important to know. So in our hands, we have different knuckles, right? And the very last knuckle, row of knuckles, closest to the tips of the fingers, are called the distal interphalangeal joints, DIP. D for distal. So if we keep going towards the wrists, the next set is going to be called the proximal interphalangeal joints, or PIP, as in proximal or closer to the center of the body. So in RA, it's very important to know that the DIP joints are spared, meaning they're usually not affected. I'm going to write spared. So the very last knuckles there are usually not going to be affected. So when RA affects the joints in our hands, it's going to affect the PIP, the proximal, kind of in the middle of the fingers. And of course, it's symmetrical, so it's going to be both sides. And as you guessed, for osteoarthritis, the DIP is not spared. So the very last joints here can be affected. But again, it's not symmetrical, so we might have these fingers on one hand and different fingers on the other hand. DIP, PIP, very important to know for physical exams and also for testing. Next, let's talk about the time of day. When is RA going to be the worst? So autoimmune diseases, this is not caused by overuse of the joints. So for patients with RA, their symptoms are going to be worst in the morning. I'm going to draw a clock here of, let's make it 8 a.m. We're not lazy, we get up at 8 a.m. And for this patient, that's going to be the worst. And as they get up and move around during the day, the stiffness gets better throughout the day. So as they use it more, the symptoms are actually lessened for rheumatoid arthritis. And since we know that OA is from overuse, you can guess that this particular feature is going to be opposite on this side. So for patients with osteoarthritis, when they first wake up, they've rested overnight, so the pain and stiffness is actually a lot better. But as they use it, it gets worse. So I'm going to draw a clock for, let's make it 3 p.m. They've had an active day, so by 3 p.m., or however, whatever other time, depending on their activity level, this is going to be the worst for them. And mornings are going to be better. Next, we'll talk about when we do the physical exam and we're looking at the joint and we're feeling it, what it might feel like. In a rheumatoid arthritis, since this is inflammation coming from the immune system attacking itself, there's going to be a warmth, an erythema, which is redness, in the joints that are affected. So as you look at it, it's going to look pinkish, different from the rest of the skin. And when you put your hand to it, it should feel warm. I'm not going to draw that around all the affected sites, but just remember that temperature, warmth, and color. And on the OA side, we're going to have some enlargement. Maybe the shape of the fingers change, and you can see the big, painful, torturous knuckles. But it's usually not going to be warm to the touch, so this side is going to be cooler. Speaking of shape, RA definitely changes the shape of the joints, dramatically so. So on this side, it's going to be more of a twisting, different shape of the joint, and in OA, it's going to be more of an enlargement. Just going down the sensory organs, on the OA side, if the patient is using the joint and you're next to them, you might hear something, and we call it crepitus, which is a sound, crepitus, which is a sound that their joints make when it's bone grinding on bone. So it's a sound of friction and grinding. It doesn't sound good coming from a joint, but it's something that's more specific to osteoarthritis than rheumatoid. Next, we'll talk about the time of onset. So this is overused. We should be born with plenty of cartilage and it wears down over time. So the onset of osteoarthritis should be slow. It should take years to develop. And the symptom, the severity should look like this. Worse over time. And over here for rheumatoid arthritis, I don't know if fast is a good word because it's a chronic disease, but I think a better word for describing the timing for RA might be random or just cyclical. They might have flare-ups, better 1 second, worse the next. So it might look like this. So as the flares go up and down, this systemic disease affects the whole body. So we might have some fever, might have some malaise, like this person is just ill overall. It's not just a joint problem. We'd have vasculitis because the immune system is attacking everything. And in the joints affected, we might develop cysts, which are fluid-filled sacs. It's the body's reaction to the inflammation, the chronic inflammation that comes from within. And on this side, we shouldn't have any fever or any bodily symptoms. But again, keep in mind that not being able to use your body is frustrating and limits the quality of life. So depression can happen, which can sometimes lead to malaise, but it should be different from this whole global picture that we get with RA. So these are some of the main symptoms that are different in RA and OA, and as you can see, they should all make sense, thinking back to why it's there in the first place, thinking back to the cause of each disease. So really, history alone, asking these questions alone, should give you a good idea of which one it is. There are more specific ways to diagnose each, but just from these symptoms right here, I think you should be able to tell rheumatoid arthritis apart from osteoarthritis.